Sweat it to the truth, nothing but the truth. Put my hands on the Bible, y'all, put me to the booth. Sweat it to the truth.
Y'all, so here's a video of Trump's bigotry before he became president. Check it out. So why is it that all those people loved him after he became president? It's like now over majority of the world hate this man. I'll tell you why. Because Trump did not embody the ideals of Americans who believe that the country should be controlled by the government or ran by the state. Now, don't get it twisted. I don't get it wrong. I did my research to understand and know and to find out that if any economy, whether it be capitalist or whether it be a socialist or any type of government, whether it be a democracy or a republic, if God is in the center of it all, and for the elected representatives, for the majority and for the minority, if God is in the center of it all, then you have a place that's going to prosper. You have a place that's going to flourish. But that's not the case with this administration that's in office right now. I'm not trying to paint this picture as Donald Trump as this saint or as this guy that's coming to save the world or as this saint. Any one of us tried to run for any type of elected official position, they can pull up dirt on any one of us. They can pull up dirt on any one of us, and that would unqualify us all. So at the end of the day, this is not about making this man out to be a saint. But this is for those Christians who would try to rebuttal that. The New Testament that you read, majority of that was written by a redeemed murderer. So please don't try to get holier than thou. And of the Old Testament, the one that you would call the greatest king of Israel, King David. This man was an alleged rapist, and I say alleged because some translations render his adultery with Bathsheba as rape. But nonetheless, he was definitely an adulterer, and he was a murderer. A first-degree murderer, might I add. Contemplated on it. He premeditated. He thought about it. He strategically planned this out. He was a first-degree murderer. And yet and still, you talk to your children about the story of David and Goliath. So please do not get holier than thou right now. But that's a side note. Back to what I was saying. This administration that's in office right now, they are totally against everything biblical at all. They're told everything that they push is antithetical to scripture. It's totally antichrist. It does not represent God in any way. As a matter of fact, they would want to replace God and make themselves be God. And they have no regards for the institutions that God has set in place, which is the family and the church. Now, they have every regard for the government because they are that. But as far as the family and church is concerned, they will want to pull those down and tear those apart because these are two pillars that help to uphold the American, to help uphold America and make the country what it is today. But therefore, abortion, which is murdering babies, let's just call it for what it is. Therefore teaching children gender ideology, then as more than a man and a woman. The Bible says that God is not the author of confusion. He's the author of order and clarity. He wants you to know what you are. Race ideology, where they literally teach white children white babies, that they are inherently racist. There is nothing that they can do about it, that their whiteness is unredeemable. It's this burden that they're going to carry around for the rest of their life, and they just have to be aware of it. And they teach black children or any color other than white that you just simply are oppressed. You're oppressed because you're not white. And so if we teach these things, we'll somehow liberate the people into the freedom that they were called to be. When I read the Bible, it tells me that God created man and God created woman, that God also created the different ethnicities because he caused a split from the Tower of Babel. Sexualized children, we see what's going on in these with these drag shows where literal drag queens are caught twerking and dry humping in front of children. At the surface of it, this might have been going on behind closed doors, but once this administration got in the office, it began to surface. It began to bubble up, it came to the top, and nobody has said nothing about it at all whatsoever. God gave us the family. He gave us the church. He gave us the government. All within their respective roles, all have certain authorities, and the family being the most important, because the family is for socializing the kids. The family is for the education, seeing the laws, the rules, the norms for the children. Without the family, we will not have a healthy society. But if you get a group of people that can tear this down and just make everybody the same, there is no classification at all amongst you, no distinction, no differences. We just throw all you in the melting pot. What you can do is you can take away the identity of all groups of people. You can take away the identities of all groups of people. And now you can be the one to come in and say, this is your identity now. This is what you can do. This is what you can do under the confines of this law. They won't tell you that Trump was about autonomy for the individual.
They want young people to feel shame and contempt for our country and for our heritage. We believe there is no force that is greater or more righteous than the power of a thing called American pride. American pride. We have American pride. They believe in left-wing gender ideology and toxic critical race theory. We believe in two genders. There are men and there are women. Two genders. And we believe that all Americans of every background are created free and equal by the hand of Almighty God. Let them say that. These are the principles we're fighting to defend each and every day. You can't teach the Bible, but you can teach children that America is evil and that men can get pregnant. A man can get pregnant. Can't even talk about the Bible. You would not trust these people to babysit your children for 20 minutes. And why should we then let them educate millions of American students 6 hours a day, year after year after year? Whatever it takes, the conservative movement must liberate America's children from the captivity of these Marxist teachers' unions. What they're doing to our children and to our country is incredible.
Because he didn't want to, and because he didn't want to support the LGBTQIA+ in that way, that was an issue for them. And so they made him out to be this racist oppressor, which is everything that I just named goes under that category, which made him out to be this racist oppressor. That's bad for America. But I digress. I'll let y'all do your research and you do your studies upon that. But you see who's pushing what, and you see what type of legislation is going out. You see, listen to what these people are talking about. And ask yourself on the inside, like, is this really right? As opposed to the legislation that he was pushing. Pushing personalities to the side. pushing personalities to the side, because again, as I said, we can all look at ourselves and say, am I qualified for anything? Heck no. But looking at legislation and what and what's being pushed, make the right judgment call off that. Love y'all. Peace. I'm out.
Tell the truth, nothing but the truth. Put my hands on the Bible, y'all. Put me to the booth. Swear to tell the truth.